Hello friends, I am Aryan and today in this video I am gonna be showing you one new app, that is a dictionary. It is a simple app and you can find any of word meanings there only. Suppose you if you don't have a dictionary, or else your dictionary may be torn out, or some meanings you are not finding. It is very difficult to find any meaning on the dictionary. I also know it because I have tried. And if it is a big dictionary, then it's next to impossible. But not impossible. If it is a small pocket dictionary, then it's okay to find a meaning. But in big dictionaries, you can't find meanings normally. And if you go to any place, then you carry your phone. So if you carry your phone, then if you use this app, this dictionary app, then you can find any of the word meanings. So let's begin. So here is the app named Offline Dictionaries. It is available on the Play Store, and the link of the app is given in the description. You can simply go there and check out the app. So let's open it. When you will first open it, then it will ask for permission to access photos, media and files on your device. Allow it. Then here it will show question, no dictionary is installed. Would you like to download dictionaries now? Then press yes. But if you press no, then nothing will happen. Then the menu option is here. You can choose any language from here, such as many languages are there: Spanish, Turkish, Portuguese. I will take the English one. So here in English, many dictionaries are there, such as English WordNet. The WordNet is the basic thing, and then English Wiktionary. Wiktionary is an online dictionary. I used to see that around 2 to 3 years before. Then English synonyms are there. Then 1913 English to word list. Then Japanese to English to Japanese. And many languages are there, such as if your regional language is Japanese, then if you know Japanese well, then you can download the English to Japanese dictionary. You can download all the dictionary also. I will only download the English WordNet. You have to click on the three dot menu and click on install. And then it will be showing that downloading. And an ad will come also. They will say you to buy the pro version. But you don't need the pro version actually. The normal version is better than the pro version, because if you take the pro version, then ads will not be showing, but they will take the money of the pro version, but one time money only. So here is it is downloading, and it is downloaded, it is installed. Then an ad will come. You have to simply press on the cross button, and then it is installed. Let's go back here, and here in the top side, suppose you have downloaded many dictionaries. I have only downloaded the English WordNet, so here one option will only come. If you download multiple, then multiple options will be coming. And if you go to the plus option, then you can download many dictionaries from here. You get here languages of English, Arabic, Chinese, Czech, Dutch, French, German, Hebrew, Hindi, that is from my country India, Irish, Italian, Japanese, Korean, Polish, Portuguese, Russian, Spanish and Turkish. So many languages are there. 18 languages are there, but that's okay, I think. And if you go to the three dot menu, you can zoom here, like in normal dictionary, we can, no, sorry, we can't. And you can make the size small also. Let me take it as 100. Yeah, it's okay. And share, you can share it with your friends. Remove ad means you have to download the pro version, and other apps means other apps from this company. So here, what the features you get? Search, normally there is showing. Dictionaries means I have shown you that many type of language you get here. Bookmark or history, this is a nice feature I will now show you. In advanced search, wildcard, that is you don't need. Text to speech is also available here. It is from your Google app only. So friends, let's search my name's meaning. A-R-Y, yeah. See, suggestions are here. So bookmark feature, here you can see the, where is Aryan is written in bold and caps. There, if you go to the right side, there is a button. Then you can write anything for this meaning. Means you can contribute. If you know the perfect meaning of that, then beside that, a bookmark option is there. If you click on that, it will be highlighted. And after that, if you go to the menu option, have bookmarks, then it will be bookmarked. Normally, if I search something, let's search sale. So after that, I am not doing anything. I have not bookmarked this. So if I go to bookmark, then it will not be showing. See, Aryan is only showing. And when you have searched, it will be also shown. So after that, history. If you go, then it will be showing that what you have searched. Then if you want to remove the history, then you have to clear the data of the app. If you clear the data of the app, then your dictionary will not be uninstalled. It will be there. Contributions means I have shown you dictionaries here. I have shown you already. Then text to speech, preferences, about, quit. This is normal, and you can join here with your Google account. So now the question will come, that the main thing of the app. So what to do after downloading any dictionary, and you, if you want to keep this app in your device permanently, so make sure that in the file manager, my one is maybe internal storage, yeah, here whatever your storage is, it may be external or it may be internal. My one is internal. So here you will get one option, dictionaries NGHS. If you click on that, there will be some options. You will think that this is an invalid option, we can't open this file, so we should uninstall. But this is the only thing you should keep. If you delete this, then I am showing you one demo. Let's delete the 46.3 MB thing. If I delete it, yeah, I have deleted. Then I go back again to the dictionary, and if I try to search anything, it will be searching. Okay, it is okay. Then suppose I removed these two also by mistakenly, suppose, and I go back again to the dictionary. If I open it, it is opening. See, no dictionary is installed. You have to again install it. So make sure that you don't delete that. Suppose you have like that, you have downloaded many dictionaries. Suppose you have downloaded almost all the dictionaries, maybe you know all the languages, then one single deletion of file can remove all your dictionaries from your app. And this app is actually offline. Let me show you. Oh, I have to download the dictionary again. Sorry. Because I have uninstalled that. It will take normally quite a little bit of time. Not so much. My internet connection is almost okay, I think. Yeah, it is okay and almost done. Yes, done. Then let me switch off the internet connection. Yeah, internet connection is switched off. Then I will again open the app from the first. So let's remove it from the recent and then again open it. See, internet is not switched on here. Wi-Fi is also not switched on. And then if I search any meaning, suppose my name only, yeah, it will be loaded. Suppose anything, yeah, bookmark is also saved. Yeah, you remember that I have saved the bookmark. It is still there. Suppose I search anonymous. Yeah, it will work. And that is the Total app. And if you love the app, then you can download from the link given in the description. And friends, if you love watching this video, then please like this video to show some support and subscribe to the channel to have more videos like this every single day. And see you soon in the next video. Till then, have a nice time. Goodbye.